Now, there's another thing called casting a variable. Now, think of a variable, like, if we say byte b, and we say int I. Now, let's just say that b, when we create it, it makes a space in the memory for b. And when we make I, it creates space in the memory for I. But obviously, the b is going to be more memory. B is going to have less space in the memory than I. So what happens if we go like this and we say b is equal to I? Because if I is like a million and b is like 10, or if we set I to a million, but b can't hold the value of a million, so it's going to have a problem here, and you can see Eclipse is giving us an error. Can't convert from int to byte. It won't let you do that, but you can do this. I is equal to b. Because it's a smaller data. Hang on. Oh. Sorry. So now we have 50. Now I will have the value of 50. You can do it the other way around because I has enough memory to hold whatever value it could possibly be in b because it has more space in it. There is one way that you can, if you really want to force it to do it for some reason, you can say b is equal to I. B is equal to I. Now, it's not going to let us do that, but there's one way you can do it. It's called casting. And you just put the type of variable right in front of it like that. And then basically it says, I don't care if that value is going to fit into this variable. I want you to make it fit into that variable. And so it's just going to take that value and it's going to force it. And so probably, I forget exactly what happens if you try and do that with a bigger number. But I think that it's going to print out whatever the maximum value that a byte can hold is. So if we run it, well, I was wrong, but it certainly didn't get the value right, did it? Because we're trying to force a value that's too big into B. So that's about it for the numeric. Oh, I can go over floating point values. Floating point, Java has two types. There's float and double. Floating point, if you guys don't know, that's basically just decimal numbers. Because the integer types that I showed you, byte, short, int, long, they can only hold whole numbers, but these can hold decimals. And float can hold the same amount of memory as an integer, and a double can hold the same amount as a long. So, you can just say float is equal to 10.5 f double d is equal to 4000.1. See, and these guys can hold these values except for this guy I'm getting an error on, because if you use a decimal like this, then Java's going to think that you're automatically trying to make a double. And like we went over before, you can't put a bigger value into a smaller value because it thinks that this is a double. And so you just go ahead and put on that F. And then it says, all right, guys, I'm declaring a float here, so don't worry about it being a double. So that's basically it for numerical data types. Characters is the... I can go over characters real quick. It's just declared as a character. Character B equals, and then put whatever you want it to be. And for characters, like I said, strings, use double quotes. Numbers, you don't use any quotes. Characters, you use the single quotes. So you could say character, okay, why don't we make it B? Because that makes way more sense, because I don't have a brain. Alright, so then you just print out B. Okay, that actually is a bad example. We're going to make character B be equal to whatever the heck that thing is. So when we do this, B is equal to that thing. So when we print out B, we should get one of those suckers. And we do. So that's a basic tutorial for you guys on variables. And probably in the next tutorial, I'll go over, well, I have no idea to tell you the truth, but we'll figure something out. So, thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. And oh, wait. I have one announcement. We have turned Megawares.net into a forum. So, if you guys have any questions, or if I stop making tutorials again and that pisses you off, and you want me to make more, or you whatever else I already said, go to Megawares.net, register for the forum. It's just starting up. We've already got a good 10 members or so, but, I mean, it's going along slow. We'll get more. So, you guys should come and register. Be one of the first members. Maybe you'll get something special. So, yeah. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next tutorial.